Hi, I'm here in my studio today and I'd like to show you a little bit about my soft Shining Feather Soft Glo glazes. I've had a lot of inquiries about them and they're not sure of exactly how to use them, so I'm going to do some little demonstrations here. The first thing I want to tell you about is these glazes are completely transparent. They're not like taking a paint and adding a glazing medium. These are totally transparent. Here's the colors that they come in, and the top is just one coat of the glaze, and this is the second coat, so you can see it darkens it, but they're still very transparent. You can see right through them. They almost look like a watercolor. Now here I took a base color and I put this first color is as close to my glaze as I could come, and I added glazing medium to it, and this is what it comes out, and it covers up the undercolor. This just brightened it, and this is the color, this is my glaze, that's the same color. And here's the paint that was the same color as my glaze, mixed with a glazing medium, and see, it just covers up the base color. And the green here is that's my green glaze. So let's just see if we can just get in here a little bit closer so you can really see this, the difference here. You can see that they're transparent and opaque. And that's what happens when you apply a paint over something with a glazing medium. Unless the paint you're using is totally transparent, which most acrylic paints are not. So this is why I developed this, because I'm actually an oil painter at heart, and when I started getting into this acrylic painting, I found that I needed something to replace the glazes that I'd been using. And there was nothing on the market, so I developed these, and I've been using them ever since. So here's a little simple painting that I've done up, and I'm just going to show you, I'm going to back that up a little bit, show you what I would glaze here and what it looks like. So I'm going to start back in here, and I'm going to take my purple glaze, primrose purple, and I'm going to apply it on the shadow area, because the shadow is not dark enough. Now see what happens is, it's not covering up my painting, it just made everything darker. Now the same with right here, this pot would actually be casting a shadow, and so I'm going to just take my primrose purple and I'm going to come over and under that a little bit where the pot would be sitting, and pull a little of the glaze out and just make a shadow on those rocks and soften it a little bit. The same with the other little pot. There would be a little shadow here and there would be a shadow underneath it. So I'm using primrose purple for that. And these glazes, you can add so many layers as you want, and it just gets deeper, richer, and the only trick is to let it dry in completely in between. Now up in this area here, you can see this little alcove. It needs some work, and let's just go in a little bit closer so you can see that. This should be a little bit darker, it's just jumping forward. So I'm going to take the purple glaze, primrose purple, and I'm just going to work it in here. And you notice that it's just simple. It's just easy to put this on, and I usually just blend it with my finger. Now that's given it a little bit darker shadow. The pot probably is dark enough, but maybe this is a little darker under here. So I'm going to darken just a tiny bit here. And then over here, there's probably more of a cast shadow on this wall. And you can see how far this goes. My glazes are so strong that they'll last you forever. They come in an ounce bottle, there's 8 colors, but I can guarantee that it'll last you a long, long time, just that little bit. Now on this pot, I'd like to add a little warmth to it, just to brighten up that shadow area. So I'm going to take some Sunset Orange and I'm going to apply that just right over the shadow area. And then I'm going to do the same on the green, just to give it a little bit of a warmth. Then maybe where this is in the highlight, the sun's on it, maybe it needs to be a little brighter. So I'm going to take just a touch of my Sunrise Yellow and put that on there. And like I said, I'm going to take a little here too. That just brought that right out. Like I said, you can work in and use as many colors as you would like and as many layers. Doesn't mean you're just stuck with one layer. Now, let's look over here, and I think the sun could be even brighter in this area, so I'm going to put the yellow back in here. And if you prefer, you can take a nice blender and blend it, but it's just a fast application. No, there's nothing that's hard about it, but it just makes everything glow. And I'm going to put a little bit more purple right here for the shadow. Come right into that pot and just bring it right up here, and then take my little blender and just soften those a little bit. And that's just giving that a little more darkness. This pot needs a little shadow here, a little more shadow here. And this is the old master's technique. And they would layer and layer and layer, many, many, many layers. Now let's have a look at these stairs. I think they could be a little bit darker, so I'm going to take a little bit of my purple or my blue and just see what the blue does here. Just on those front of the stairs that are in the shadow. And that darkened it quite a bit. Let's just come in a little bit closer. And if you want it a little darker than that, you can go ahead and add a little purple, which will just even make it more look like more of a shadow there. There now, those are really looking dark. Now this area, maybe I'd like to have a little more sun on that area, so I'm going to just add a little bit of my Sunrise Yellow on this area. And it's a very thin application, but you can see here's the sun hitting these little rocks. This area is done and this area isn't, so you can really see the difference. So let's go ahead and finish that real quickly. And then I think the edge of the step probably needs a little bit of that too, seeing that the sun's hitting it there. So we'll just go ahead and add just a touch of the glaze there, and that's done. And come back and maybe add a little bit here so it looks like the sun's really coming in. Now, this little pot could have some orange on it, just to make it look a little brighter. So I'm going to use Sunset Orange here. And I'm going to pull it right around, and you can see that that really changed it. That's just warmed that right up. Now, I did put yellow in here, but I don't think it's quite yellow enough, so I'm going to do it again with a little orange this time. Just a touch of orange, and then I'm just going to take my blender and blend that around a little bit. And that warmed that up an awful lot. Now, let's look at the flowers. They could be really changed somewhat. Let's try, and it's fun to just experiment, let's try my pink and see what this does on these. Oh, that's making them look really pretty, really, really rich. I like that a lot. Let's just let that dry. And then let's just go over to the orange flowers here. And let's see what we're gonna do there. Let's look at the pot first. The pot probably could use a little orange in the shadow area. So I'm going to put a little bit, and I'm going to pull it right over the whole pot to just warm that up completely. And then let's put some yellow over some of these orange flowers and see if that was what we like. That changed them dramatically. You can see that this is lighter here than over here. And maybe some of these are in the shadow. And you know, sometimes everything isn't in the sun. So I'm going to take a little purple and I'm going to put some of these back in the shadow a little bit. Just deepen them a little tiny bit so there's a little more depth than I've painted them. Now you can see they're starting to look like they have a little bit more depth there. Up in this corner, I painted some greenery. And this is a kind of a purple shadow, but I'd like to have a little glow in there. So I'm going to add a little bit of orange right over the shadow area and over the leaves. And I use a lot of purple and orange and green because green's boring just by itself. So I'm going to bring that down just a little bit on the stucco. And I'm going to do a little bit up in here too. Then I'm just going to take the little blender and just soften the edges. And that's made that look a lot warmer. Now this edge right here has a lot of sun on it, but it could have more. I could really intensify the light if I just glazed a little more light in there with my orange. And I didn't have to redo anything. And it doesn't matter if I go over the leaves. A little more light over here. Now this looks like this is bathed in the sun. That's really a nice effect. Let's look at this big pot here and let's just darken this pot a little bit with a little purple glaze and work a little bit in there, work a little bit in here. Just soften it a little bit. You can see how easy I'm doing this. It's really not anything that's real difficult. And then let's just add a little of the yellow up in here to make it a little brighter so it looks like it's more in the sun than it looks like now. And then I could add some of the yellow over some of these leaves and brighten them up. And I also could add some pink tones to some of these little flowers. Just a touch, and that'll just give them a little bit of a difference. So now you can see how much I can change everything around just by using a glaze, and it's a wonderful thing to learn how to do. And if you take time to just experiment, you'll find out there's a lot more you can do. Now here's a little tiny painting that I've been working on. Let's just come in a little bit and show you. The sky looks kind of uninteresting, but I'm going to take just a little bit of orange and come in here where there's a little bit of color. And a lot of times when you're painting, you're afraid to get that much color in. So you don't. You just leave it. And you could make it so much better by adding a glaze. Now that's already helped that right there. And then in here, it could be a richer tone. So let's just try using a little of the yellow. Oh, I had some orange on me, on my brush, but that's okay. Let's just blend that a little bit. Pull it over. And you can see what it's done already without much work. I didn't have to go back in and rework that sky, which nobody likes to have to do. Now on these mountains, I can just put a little bit of the orange. And even if I got it into the sky, it doesn't matter because I can just blend that. And that's going to pull that up a lot. But if I wanted to add a little more shadow and depth, I could just do it with my purple and just pull that into the shadow areas. And you can see how much darker that is than over here. It hasn't been darkened with it, and you can just blend it around. And if you don't like it, you can just wipe it right off. Now, let's look at this foreground here. These bushes really need something, and they need to be brightened up a little bit. So I'm going to add some yellow to them and pull some bright into that little yellow. Now, there you can see the difference between the two. On this one, I could put a little yellow orange glaze, just work it in. And even if you got it on the background color, it's not going to do anything but warm it up. And there's the difference between the two. Look at these little sage brushes. Now maybe I could change that completely, and I'm going to try just taking a little bit of my signature turquoise color, and I'm going to put that right in here just to make that a little greener blue. And then I'm going to take some purple and put the purple into the shadow areas where it needs to be really darkened down a little bit. And again, you can just tap the edges lightly, and you have a little bit different there. On the other side of that, now you can see the difference here and here. That's a little bluer, but if you didn't want it blue and you wanted more sunlight on it, then you would pick up some yellow and change it to a yellow. And just work it into the background, doesn't matter. And then still again, I think it needs to be darker down in here and have a little bit of purple just to break up the green. And so I would just add a little bit of purple, just soften it out a little bit. These bushes back in the background, they have a glow on them, but it's not doing as much as I'd like. So I'm going to take my orange and I'm going to add an orange glow to these mountains, or these bushes. And I'm going to go over the whole bush, and look what happens to that bush. Now we have a glow. Here's the same kind of bush. So you can understand how I do this and why I like it, because it is just so easy. The finishing touches on my paintings, this is how I get the depth, and this is how the old masters got the depth. They worked with glaze upon glaze. A lot of them started with a grisaille underpainting, which was done in white and black. But I work with colors. Then I layer the colors over the other colors. And you can see that it just enhances the whole painting. And everything is going to look richer and much prettier. Now, you can even take the orange and hit that ground like the sun's coming on it. Get all the little rocks in there. You could introduce a little more orange into there if you'd like, and a little more yellow. And then up in the sky, I really like to put some orange into my purple clouds, because it gives them so much more personality. So I always add a little bit. And I know you've seen skies painted with many colors, and This is the way some of the oil painters get it, is with this wonderful glazing method. So I hope that gives you an idea of how to use them. They're going to be on sale on my website. I'm going to have an introductory little mini kit that you can try out, and I'm sure you'll want to order the bigger size for yourself, because it will last forever. Once you start glazing your paintings with this, you'll never go back to leaving them unglazed. So thank you again for joining me in my studio, and I'll see you next time.